Well, political consultant Julius Henson took the stand today in the trial charging him with election fraud. Prosecutors say Henson designed the robocalls in 2010 with the intent of suppressing the African-American vote. 11 News I-Team reporter Barry Sims is live outside the Mitchell Courthouse tonight with more. Barry.
Well, Julius Henson told jurors about his job and why robocalls were important to getting his clients elected.
I'm on the stand testifying, and I think that should remain in the courthouse, but I'll be happy to talk to you when my testimony is over.
Julius Henson is now telling the jury his version. While working for the Bob Ehrlich campaign for governor in 2010, he developed a robocall, but Henson denies it was intended to suppress the African-American vote. For about an hour and 15 minutes Friday, Henson described how he was one of the first to use robocalls, saying they were effective and inexpensive. They could contact a home, then get the recorded message to a voter in under 30 seconds. The cost? Less than 3 cents per call. Henson said of the more than 100 clients he's had, most were Democrats. He was interested in playing a key strategic role in Republican Ehrlich's campaign, but he claims, quote, they wanted to pigeonhole me to African-American outreach, unquote. He said they wanted him to go work with the black people and bring in their votes. State prosecutors charged Henson with election fraud. They contend the robocall, which went to 100,000 in Baltimore City and Prince George's County, suggested the election was over before the polls closed, was designed to suppress the black vote, and did not contain an authority line as required by law. Henson claims he was trying to get more people to go to the polls. As his trial continues, he remains confident.
Vindication is a great thing. And I just say that I'm fortified by tens of thousands of people praying all over this country and will be victorious.
Now, jurors will hear more about that particular robocall on Monday. That's when Julius Henson will again take the witness stand. Reporting live from downtown Baltimore, Barry Sims, WBAL-TV 11 News.